Hey everybody, hope you're having a great weekend. It's Sunday and the store is closed today, but I was in here and walked around a little bit and I saw quite a few products that I didn't even know we had in stock. So that's really awesome. We're finally starting to get some new stuff because it's been so hard to get just about everything. But we have some great new things in here and I'll take you around, show you around, show you where a few things are. Now, first of all, I got some new rods in. These are the rods built here in Woodland, 100% made here in Woodland, just down the road by, it's a factory owned by Brad Loomis and his partner Jake Cars, and then Oscar, he used to be the rod builder for Lamaglass. He's got his own thing going, and he's right in there with them building all these rods, and they're really awesome rods. I couldn't be happier with the rod situations. I've had rods here in the past because it's a difficult business to deal with, but this is a good situation where I've got really good, high quality, locally made rods, not for too outrageous of a price. You know, you're gonna pay a full, you know, price for a domestic, you know, quality rod like this, but they're worth it. They're awesome and they're selling really well. So I've got some new stuff. I've got is the got some 12 foot salmon rods here. These are the 360 style trolling rods, and then also 10.5 foot and 9.5 foot. So these are the 12 footers, which would go on your bow. You know, you want to hang 16, 20 ounces of lead off your bow and keep things spread out. Well, that's the rod that's going to do it for you. They're really awesome. And then the 9.5 and 10.5 foot, you know, your standard trolling rods. They've got the green tips on them. So I started with the kokanee rods here with the green tips because I couldn't see the tip. That was kind of for me. I just wanted to be able to see the tip better because, you know, early in the morning and the trees and all that. I when I was fishing the prototypes of these, I couldn't see them. So I said, well, put the green tip on there so I can see the dumb rod. And then somebody, you know, and this has been real popular, the green tip, but somebody ordered, I think, four of these salmon rods, but they ask for the green tips to be on the salmon trolling rods. So I was like, okay, well, just make them all that way. So anyway, the salmon trolling rods and the kokanee rods are all going to have the green tips like this. You need to see it better. And then also right here, this is my rod I've got rigged up here, but this is a 12.5 foot bank fishing rod. See the big old handle on it. You can cast this thing a mile if you wanted to, or if you're doing the sandbag thing. But 12.5 feet of just raw power with a tip that's loose enough to where you're actually going to be able to see the bite. And I went ahead and had them put the green tip on this rod also. So that thing is awesome for, you know, the fishing the sandbags off the beach, or if you're surf casting, you want to cast, you know, 16 ounces of lead or something halfway across the Columbia, this is the rod that'll do it for you. So I'll have, this is the only one I've got in store right now, this one's mine, but there are several coming. I think I should probably have them next week. So those are really cool. And then also, I got bobber rods now. So this is 100% graphite, 9.5 foot bobber rod. If you like the lightness and sensitivity of 100% graphite, then that's the rod you want. And those have actually been the better seller, which is a little surprising, because I've got the same rod in a composite. So this is graphite and fiberglass. And it's just super strong, tough and durable. And for bobber fishing, you know, I don't think sensitivity is all that important. It's not like they're not sensitive at all, but just compared to 100% graphite. But these composite bobber fishing rods, I think, are just fantastic. They've been selling well, but I still have a few in here, and there's more coming. So those are just 9.5 foot bobber rods. And then also, I've got, let's see over here, I finally got these in. So these are 7.5 foot. I got, well, in the 7.5 foot, it's 4 power and 5 power. So the 4 power, really good for twitching, hover fishing with lighter leads. And then the 5 power, which just means a little stiffer, more material, a little stiffer action. Really good for hover fishing. You know, the bigger leads are going to use like 6 ounces or 8 ounces or whatever. That's just fantastic. Or jigging out in the ocean.
you can, the four powers, you can back troll, you know, like wigglers and whatever lures with those for salmon. Awesome for casting baits. Sell a lot of these down in California, Sacramento River. You guys want a salmon fish and striper fish in the same day, this is the rod they'll do it. Very versatile. And then also, I don't have any here now, but I've got the three power coming, which is a lighter rod. So it's basically, here's the original Ray Thurford blue rod that I made years ago. It's a lamiglass rod. So these now that I'm having made are in replacement of these lamiglass rods. But so I will have the three power, four power, and five power in both spinning and casting. Hopefully all by, I think this next week, I think they were just about done. So it's been a struggle to get them all in here at the same time, because by the time I get another version of it, I've sold out of the ones I had before. So it's just hard to keep them all in stock, which is a good thing. But I'm hoping to be able to just have these in stock and available, you know, on a regular basis here real soon. So the three power, 7 foot long, a nice kind of little softer tip, great for casting for down in California, casting for stripers, you know, for a lighter rod, this is a really good option. Or the four power and the five power, just depending on what you need. Now this is a rod right here that I was using just the other day on the Skagit River. I was twitching with it, and I put my ballistic 2500 on there, which is an awesome reel. I love the ballistic reels, and I'd have them here in the shop, just can't get them, you know, they're just not available. But the problem with this rod, you see, that's 2500 size reel, which you think would be just, you know, perfect for this sort of thing, but they're so light these days, it's just unbelievable. And if you watch, look at, see that, it doesn't balance, this rod, it's so light, even though it's a 2500, it doesn't balance like it should. So I'm gonna go out later today on the Lewis, and I'm gonna spool up one of these. This is the Eliminator 4000, and it's a lot heavier reel than that, but I think it's gonna balance on that rod really well. And I've sold several of these with the bobber rods, and they balance really well on there. So this is a really good option for a 4000 size reel with a lot of line capacity and a lot of speed on your pickup. It picks up a lot of line in a hurry, which for bobber fishing is really important. But I think it's gonna balance on these rods really well too. And these are just bulletproof. It's actually a saltwater reel. So, you know, you can go out and cast jigs for, you know, when a rockfish are shallow or lungcod or whatever, you can do all the ocean fishing you want with this. But the best thing about them is they're only $100, $99. And that's the regular full retail price on them, which I think is just a really good deal. I was fortunate to kind of get it. The rep turned me onto these, and I'm glad I got them. So I got quite a few of them, and hopefully I can get more, because I think this is a really good reel for a lot of the fishing that we do around here. And we just got Twistex back in stock, you know, for making your own spinners, and we got the wires and clevises and blades and everything you need, you know. But people have been looking for these because they were a victim of COVID. The factory that was making them here in the States, and anyway, that factory couldn't make them anymore because of the whole COVID thing. But it looks like they're still made in the States. I don't see where it says made in, oh yeah, it says made in USA right there. So they found another manufacturer. So that's good. They did go up in price, and that's just like everything else. So they're $146.32 now. Came up with that price, but yeah, so that's a pretty significant price increase, but it is what it is. You know, we can't do anything about that. Finally, see, we got some blue fox in. You know, those are real popular around here. Get on the salmon of those. Got a pretty decent selection of those, and that was just about impossible to get for a long time, but we finally got some blue foxes in. So got some cast masters and quite a few rooster tails, pro releases. Oh, and there's some clamming tides coming. Got a lot of good clamming opportunities coming up in the next few months. So these Fishfield clam guns, these lightweight aluminum ones, these things are fantastic. They got the, you know, the hole in them right here for your finger, you know, to release the suction. And you know, I mean, they're built right and real strong, real light. They're awesome. Those are $40. Then we have the $15 PVC guns, which work too. They're just not nearly as nice as the aluminum ones, But if you ever want to do some clamming, this coming up here real soon is a good time to be doing some clamming. Got some great tides, and there's a lot of them. And then we got the new Fishfield bags, the Surf and Jetty bags. Now here's the older original version. And then this is basically the same thing, but it's got these nice pockets built in. So these are great for surf perch fishing. You know, you hang them over your shoulder. They hold a little bit of water, help keep your fish fresh. And it's not like a cooler where you can keep your fish all day. And so you can't fill up a bag like this full of water and carry it around. It's just too heavy. But just a little bit of water and keep your fish fresh while you're out there fishing in the water. And the water, you know, you're sanded in the water and that bag's going to be hanging down into the water a little bit. So it really is a good system. Got a lot of thirsty bees, soft bees, you know, winter's coming, got the steelhead. Hopefully you're going to have a good steelhead year. And we're already starting to see an increase in the sales on these things because people are stocking up, which is smart. I mean, just the way things are going, if you think you're going to be using something several months from now, start shopping now, because by then it might not be available. And then we got the cold water strong stuff here. This has been real popular. Oh man, only one of the main lines left, but I think we've ordered more. I'm sure we've ordered more, so hopefully those will be coming soon. But really good quality. I've been using those a little bit myself, and I really do like the precision to it. The engineering on these things is amazing just for a leader. You know, I think how simple is that, but the way they're built, they really are good leaders. We got some Tripsy Divers and Spro. We got stocked up on all the Spro stuff. We got a few Wigglers. I hear there's more Wigglers coming. We'll see. But we're fully stocked on the Spro RkStar plugs. So if Coho, you can get on those Coho, you know, and also the jigs. We did Pink Show the other day on the Skagit. And you gotta watch the show. So it's gonna be good. This pink and white. Well, no, actually it was the purple. This one right here and the pink and white. We got them on both. But we're catching pinks and pinks and pinks. And then we got I think three coho. And the coho all came on these jigs. And you know, a lot of pinks on these jigs too. But we're also using just some kind of hoochie on a regular jig head. And that was working for the pinks too. But it's interesting that the coho that's the only jig they hit where the Spros. So that marabou and those two little tails look like a shrimp. They really work well for coho. You know, the thing is, you know, like these switching jigs here, you got the arrow jig, switching jigs with the big rabbit fur and all that, you know, real big bodied things. You got to really make those, you got to twitch them hard to give them action because there's a lot of stuff, you know, built, you know, tied around that hook. Whereas these Spros, the way we design them, they're very sparse. And you know, you hear that in the fly fishing world about, you know, sparse is better. Well, it's true that the action that this has just on its own, plus with the larger half ounce and three quarters have the two longer feathers here. You know, when that's just sitting in the water, that's really a lot of action going on there that a jig like this isn't gonna have. You gotta really put the action onto this, whereas these, you can be a little more subtle with it, with your twitching, because there's a lot more going on with that marabou and those two feathers. And those two feathers look like a shrimp. And the fish just attack them a lot harder than other types of jigs. So if you're fishing the Spro, you know, try this a little more subtle and let that jig do the work. Okay, here's these wild fin rod holders. Now these are really well made. Take a look at those welds on there. These are made here locally, I think in Kalama. But this guy, you know, he's a local guy, you know, but I know a little bit about welding. You know, I used to do some welding back in the day, and I looked at those welds, like, man, this guy's good. You know, it's pretty impressive on aluminum like this, but nice lightweight aluminum. And these handles here, you can really push down and, you know, get that down into the sand. So I like these wild fin rod holders a lot. And you really want to get fancy, get the stainless steel. These Fishfield ones are just bulletproof. You know, you can just pound them in with a hammer through the rock and whatever, you know, indestructible stainless steel, really good quality. And then we got some of these Fishfield stick weights. If you want to try out a stick weight for trolling, you know, those are getting real popular. You don't get hung up as much, but these are good stick weights from Fishfield we got here. Look here. We finally got some Pro Trolls. I guess this is where they're going to go. We just got these in. So we got some Pro Trolls in stock. So I know some of you guys are gonna be happy about that. We got them just in time for them to close the river, but oh well. You know, they if you wanna get stocked up on some Pro Trolls, there you go. And of course we've got all the bobbers, you know, fish field. The wobbler section's looking a little dismal. We did get restocked on a few colors of the brads. Here's some nightmare jigs here from Arrow Jig. I didn't even know we had those. So that's cool. Put those on a different place maybe. And then these pixie spoons. You ever tried a pixie spoon? They work really well. We've got some MIPS. We got some other stuff. Oh, we got some here. These haven't been put up yet. We've got some flying seas and some different MIPS. And oh, look at this. Okay, you've seen these? Now I did a show that it's gonna air first week of October on new channel. Okay, so the NBC Sports Northwest going off the air at the end of September. So the Angler West is gonna be seen on the CW network in Portland and Seattle in the Northwest. It stays the same in California on NBC Sports California. But in the first show on the CW network coming up first week of October with John Kaiser, Uncle Jerry out there in Owako, and we're trolling Fish Flash with these stuck to them. Now these are lights that just stick to whatever you stick them to, and you push that little button and they either stay on or they blink. You know, there's different functions, but these lights are really cool. You're going to see these in a show, so we've got some of these in stock now. You might want to try one of those. Oh, and we got lead. Holy smokes, look at all this lead we got. We got it covered. Looks like we're 100% stocked. That's been a long time coming there. But we got tons of 16s, got 20s, and then check this out, 18s. I've never seen an 18 before, but there you go, 18 ounces. And this is, I think, at least the second batch, because I know the first box we got sold in like the first day, and yeah, so 16s are popular, and we got 24s also. And then in these drawers, we've got all the egg sinkers and some good steelhead jigs. You know, you want to make your own steelhead jigs. You got pencil lead in here and a bunch of these no roll kind of inline lead weights. Oh, and here's brand new stuff that I hadn't taken a close look at yet, but I got all the Dave's Tangle for you. I think it's everything he makes. Stainless steel weights, you know, and then the new stick weights. Got all these and little pro packs. And then I gotta open one of these up, see what's all going on here. But the kokanee pack and the salmon pack, then you got trout pack, steelhead pack, and then the inline pack. And I'll have to admit, I'm not exactly 100% sure what's in all those. I gotta open one of these up, but we just got these in. And but the, you know, of course, Dave's Tanglefree is real popular around here for a long time, so we got stocked up on those. And we got all the terminal tackles, really good high quality Spro stuff. The tornado chain swivels, and the glasses, and then, oh yeah, the glasses we got now. See, I ran into these guys at ICAST, you know, big fishing show in Florida, and these are my glasses here, but see how those go on there? But these are, for me, these are like the really good, you know, to hang around your neck. So we've got these cables in here. See, different styles. Different prices, $8.99, $11.99, different styles. But these right here, these are the ones. Please come on in the shop, subscribe, you know, and put out some specials and different things to show you what's going on. So make sure you subscribe to the channel and come on in the shop here, Woodland, Washington. We're open Monday through Saturday, you know, every day but Sunday, 9 to 5. So we'd love to see you in the shop. So come on in, say hi.